Long-time observers of Korean politics know that the partisan divide in the country runs along a generational fault line, one that pits older voters, shaped by post-war poverty and dramatic economic growth amid Cold War competition, against now middle-aged voters, who grew up in relative prosperity but bristled against political repression as they came of age. The latter band of voters, initially dubbed the 386 generation in the 1990s, from being in their 30s at the time, attending university in the 80s, and being born in the 60s, have formed a reliable voting bloc for Korean progressives once the country became a full-fledged democracy in 1987, even as they have now entered their 50s. However, while the two generations' respective loyalties for Korea's political parties persist, even as factions on both sides of the aisle have merged, split, or simply rebranded with a change of name, that ideological framework appears increasingly obsolete to a new generation, the so-called 2030 generation. The 2030 generation is comprised of young adults in their 20s and 30s who, despite growing up in the most liberal and affluent period of Korea's modern history, are also most vulnerable to increasing job insecurity, unaffordable housing, and the widening socioeconomic divide. The reality lived by this generation is encapsulated by popular terms they coined, such as gold spoon and dirt spoon, which denote the divergent expectations of society's haves and have-nots. While 2030 voters are not particularly invested in either of Korea's two major political camps, which are embodied by the ruling Democratic Party, or DP, and the main opposition People Power Party, also known as the PPP, polls from this past winter have provided a glimpse into how their societal outlook affects their voting preferences. Shortly after Kim Gon-hee, wife of PPP presidential candidate Yoon Suk-yeol, was hit by accusations in December that she padded her resumes for university teaching posts with fabricated career credentials, the Chungha-ilbo survey conducted on December 30th and 31st showed a pronounced swing among survey respondents in the 2030 generation, with Yoon hemorrhaging 19 percentage points in support from voters in their 30s and almost 9 percentage points from voters in their 20s.
최순실 씨가 박근혜 대통령의 연설문 등 각종 청와대 문건을 공개 전에 미리 받아보고 수정도 했다는
The downfall of former President Park Geun-hye was precipitated by revelations in 2016 that Park's longtime confidant, 최순실, leveraged her ties to the president to extract funding from Samsung to her daughter's dressage career and even pressured Ewha Women's University to create a special admissions track for equestrians the same year her daughter applied to college. Following Park's impeachment, then-DP candidate Moon Jae-in was elected president in May 2017 on a successful campaign pledge to eradicate deep-rooted evils that assembled a coalition between the DP's traditional reform-minded supporters and younger voters seething at the extraordinary privileges enjoyed by Choi and her daughter.
아니면 그토록 청산하고자 했던 적폐의 연장이 될 것인가?
However, the DP discovered accusations of privilege could be a double-edged sword when charges of similar gold spoon treatment were levied against the daughter of Choguk, Moon's pick for the post of Justice Minister, just as Cho was undergoing the nomination process in autumn 2019. Cho's daughter was revealed to have been listed as a co-author of a highly advanced pathology research paper when she was only a high school student, a suspicious achievement she used to win a spot at Korea University and later Pusan University's graduate medical school. These allegations struck a nerve among the younger generation and ignited mass protests calling for the withdrawal of Cho's nomination, and Moon's approval ratings tanked as he stood by his nominee. Given this history, perhaps it is not particularly surprising that the resume padding scandal surrounding Yoon's wife sparked a swing of young voters away from him. Perhaps conscientious of his falling appeal to millennials, the PPP candidate announced shortly after the start of the new year that he would reorient his presidential campaign to accommodate their concerns. "From now on, I will carry out my campaign alongside the 2030 generation," Yoon announced on January 5th. One way in which Yoon has attempted to tap into the youth vote is to pick up a hot, albeit divisive, issue among the 2030 generation: feminism. In a Facebook post on January 3rd, Yoon apologised for picking 31-year-old feminist politician Shin Ji-ye as chair of a now disbanded party committee, saying that he had failed to read the minds of those in their 20s and 30s, and admitting he had greatly disappointed the younger generation. In another Facebook post on January 8th, which read simply, "Abolish the Ministry of Gender Equality and Family," Yoon targeted an institution whose function and name is perceived by young men as promoting women's rights at the expense of their own. While the PPP candidate focused on channeling male anger within the 2030 generation into votes, his DP rival Lee Jae-myung has attempted to address feminism without picking a side. Lee, who on January 2nd said he does not wish to encourage gender conflict to win votes, has also pointedly refused to defend feminist ideas of correcting gender discrimination. Instead, the DP candidate said he hopes that a time might come when politicians could focus on helping people rather than women, saying the focus on women was unavoidable because of the disadvantage in society at a January 9th panel discussion on online sex crimes. The 2030 generation is the focus of both major candidates' outreach because this age group is the largest undecided bloc in the electorate. The Korean 2030 generation's disconnect from the traditional ideological paradigm also leaves their votes open to grabs if candidates can target the issues that matter to them. While the Chungha-yebo survey conducted just before the new year showed that Yoon was the least preferred candidate among voters in their 20s, trailing even An Cheol-soo of the minor opposition People's Party, by the time of a second Chungha-yebo survey on January 15th and 16th, he had gained a whopping 16.9 percentage points in support among voters in the same age group, soon after his campaign focus shifted towards young men. All told, the dramatic shifts in candidate support driven by members of the 2030 generation suggest they will be a potent voting bloc for whoever can win their ballots.